What's up, guys? I'm Justin Ball, and welcome back to The Recording Percussionist, where I show you everything you need to know to get from that beginning stage of looking at a microphone or camera for the very first time to that intermediate stage where you feel confident in your ability to set up, record, and edit an entire recording session all on your own. In the audio interface video, I mentioned sample rate and bit rate. You've seen these terms before, but today's the day that you learn what these mean and why they're important. To help you understand, a little bit of review goes a long way here. Think back to the first video in the series and the shape of a sound wave. A single wave cycle consists of both high and low pressure waves. Amplitude refers to the height of the wave, determining how loud the sound is. And frequency refers to the space between wave cycles, determining how high or low it is. When sound is captured by the microphone, it becomes an analog or electrical signal. This analog signal is continuous, without an interruption, just like we hear sound with our own ears. However, when it reaches the audio interface, it's then converted to digital audio using a process called sampling. Think of sampling as snapshots, similar to the frame rate of a camera. A video consists of tons of photos per second, which, when played back quickly, imitate motion. In theory, the more frames shot per second, the more smooth the video appears. Sample rate works in a similar fashion. In order to effectively reproduce a given frequency, a sample needs to be taken at least twice per wave cycle, meaning one sample for the high pressure wave and another for the low pressure wave. Remember that humans can only hear frequencies between 20 Hz and 20 kHz or 20,000 Hz. So, in order to capture the highest possible sound that we can hear at 20,000 Hz, we would need a sample rate of at least 40,000 samples per second. In general, the higher the sample rate, the more precise the recreation of the original audio is going to be, and the cleaner our audio sounds. You also get bigger file sizes the higher you go, but it's not nearly as significant as video sizes. Okay, that's cool, but that doesn't explain why the most common sample rates we see are 44.1 and 48 kHz. Well, I hate to burst your bubble, but neither am I, because we'd have to get into low-pass filters, aliasing, putting digital audio onto VHS tapes, and you've already been through enough. For now, just think of it as overcompensating for that 40 kHz mark, and I'll put a link in the description if you're interested in learning more. Some claim that humans can't tell the difference between 44.1 and 48 kHz sample rates, but I beg to differ. While it's not a huge difference, there is a difference and it is audible. However, it is very subtle, and there are other factors that affect which one we should be recording with other than how it sounds. One of the main factors in deciding which sample rate to use is how you plan to deliver the final product. If you're planning to put it on a CD, the standard sample rate for CD audio is 44.1 kHz. Some people actually prefer to record at a higher sample rate and convert it at the end of the editing process before putting it onto a CD. 48 kHz is the standard for video audio, and is what I've been using this entire series to record these videos. For the purpose of percussion recordings, I also think that a sample rate of 48 kHz is the best way to go. Okay, so sample rate refers to how we capture frequency information, but what about amplitude? Well, this is where bit depth comes into play. Remember that analog audio is continuous, and samples are taken at certain intervals per second based on our sample rate to effectively reproduce a given frequency. On a graph, these samples are measured horizontally. Therefore, the amplitude value is dependent on the exact location the sample is taken from. So, in order to accurately gauge the correct amplitude, we also need a similar set of vertical values. Bit depth tells us the number of possible amplitude values available for each individual sample. The higher the bit depth, the more possible vertical amplitude values we have, and the more precisely we're able to record the exact amplitude of a given sample. A higher bit depth also means a wider dynamic range. The most common bit depths include 16, 24, and 32-bit. 16-bit provides 65,536 values and offers a total dynamic range of 96.3 decibels. 24-bit provides around 16.7 million values with a dynamic range of 144.5 decibels, and 32-bit provides over 4 billion values, offering a dynamic range of 1,528 decibels, which is absurd considering the greatest theoretical difference in sound pressure on this planet is 210 decibels, but that's a topic for another day. Depending on the bit depth, the exact amplitude value is rounded up or down to the nearest value, using a process called quantization. The higher the bit depth, the more fluid our sample looks, and the lower the bit depth, the more choppy it looks. So which one should we be using, and how does it interact with sample rate? 16-bit 44.1 kHz is the standard for CDs. 24-bit 48 kHz is the standard for video audio, including DVDs. In general, I would try to steer clear of 32-bit because, again, this is for ultra-high dynamic range recordings, which we won't be dealing with, and you'll be hard-pressed to find an entry-level audio interface that records at 32-bit. To cap it all off, for the purpose of percussion recordings, I recommend recording at 24-bit and 48 kHz sample rate. There you have it, folks, sample rate and bit depth. Thanks so much for watching, I hope you learned something, and if you feel like you're benefiting from this, consider subscribing, and check out the next video where we discuss creating a controlled recording environment. Till then, happy recording.